The Acer Predator Helios 300-2017 was a great laptop and it was very popular in the Nepali market. It offered one of the best internals and specifications and well was a good value for money. And this time around, Acer has launched its successor, the Acer Helios 300-2018, which tries to better the Helios 300-2017. So I got my hands on this laptop a few weeks ago and here is what I think about this gaming machine. So let's start by talking about the aspect where the 2017 edition fell short, and that is the thermals. So Acer seems to have done its homework this time, and this machine can keep itself pretty cool even after long sessions of gaming. The software inside lets you spin the fans to its fastest, and with this feature, the laptop throttled a lot less than I expected it to. Well, it did throttle sometimes, but not to the amount of bothering me. The fan does make quite a bit of noise to keep the laptop cool, reaching up to 6000 RPM, although I am not complaining. The laptop is primarily meant for gamers and at a glance you can see it giving the gaming vibe. The outer part of the Acer laptop has a metallic build, although the base is made of plastic, which I think could have been better. There is red accent everywhere and I kind of like it. But you have to keep in mind that this is a gaming laptop and even if you're not a gamer, I like almost everything about the design of this laptop. Some of my instances with laptop displays have been polarizing. Some of them feature a quality display while some are just not there. And this one here falls in the former category with its FHD resolution. With its 144Hz display, you get a top quality display panel which I have no complaints about. The 144Hz refresh rate really helps make the computer feel fast and the speed is noticeable even when you keep it besides a 120Hz one. Even the movement of the mouse cursor is fun to watch, no matter how you use it, you just can't help but appreciate the display. There's a huge downside to that choice though, and that is the pricing. With this 144Hz display, it will cost you a lot more, but is it worth it? Yes, it is. It will give you an advantage over the others because with this one, you are seeking more than what you usually do. You are not going to be a great gamer for sure, but you will just have a lot more fun on this laptop compared to a 60Hz laptop. If you dive into specs, the 92% sRGB color coverage just seals the deal. Usually with gaming laptops, one would expect a bad display, but with this one, no matter if you are gaming, editing photos, videos, or even just watching a movie, it's just better. Well, yes, compared to the MSI GE63 Raider, the color accuracy lacks a bit, but nothing that would be a deal breaker. Right off the bat, this is probably the most processing power one can buy at this price. There's a huge bump in the performance if the 7th and 8th generation chipsets are compared, and the same thing is seen here with this laptop because with this one you get a huge performance boost. In my experience, it can handle everything you do. It's one of the best ones around for gaming, for productivity, and even for editing or video rendering. The 16GB RAM inside helps for this cause as it efficiently handles all the intensive tasks. You get two RAM slots and both are used. If you want to upgrade, you obviously will have to replace both the RAM sticks. Now, GTX 1060 on any hardware is always amazing. However, in this instance, the GPU does not pair well with the 144Hz display. And this is seen while gaming. To make use of the display, I always had to lower the graphics significantly so that I could reach 144fps. Otherwise, on higher settings, games barely cross 100fps mark. So this one is entirely up to you. You can choose crisp graphics quality or smoothness. Talking about my gaming experience, I played games in both the high and low settings to make full use of the GPU and the display respectively. And in my experience, I really love making full use of the 144Hz panel. While I definitely love playing games on the highest of the settings, the fluid gameplay attracted me more. During my FIFA 19 gaming session, I lowered the graphics for higher refresh rate, and that experience was just amazing. The bad graphics was never a match for the fluid gameplay experience. Once you play on one of these displays, there is no going back. And even the first-person shooter games like CS:GO was definitely better on this laptop here. However, there are areas where the GTX 1060 falls a couple of setbacks. High resource intensive games like PUBG barely cross 90fps even under extremely low settings at FHD resolution. This isn't bad, but it just feels unsatisfying for some reason. In terms of storage, the Helios 300 features 256GB of SSD, which produced good results when I tested out its speed. The storage provides a read speed of up to 1575 MB per second, while the write speed stands at 597 MB per second. So with those numbers at helm, the storage is definitely fast and the laptop runs quite smoothly without any hiccups. The laptop I reviewed only had 256 GB of storage, but you can add a hard drive if you want extra storage besides the SSD. Let's talk about the battery life now. This is the area where most of the performance-oriented devices fail to shine. And over the years, I have reviewed quite a few gaming laptops, and what was common in all of them was all of them had poor battery life. The same goes with the Acer Helios 300. A 48-watt-hour battery is pretty low to begin with. Combine that with a 144Hz display and a 6-core processor, what you get is 2-3 hours of battery life, which gets lower when I game. Gaming laptops have a poor battery life as I discussed earlier, but this one here is the definition of bad battery life. The keyboard on the Helios 300 too has that red accent to it that could be captivating to some. The aesthetics are great, but in terms of usability, I didn't quite like it because it is really mushy and just does not give you that clicky feedback that we all love. The key travel and the quality of the keyboard itself seem fine though. Also, the orientation of the keys seem a little cluttered. Take the power button for an example. It is just another key on the top right. The shift key is just too small for my taste as I constantly pressed another button thinking it was shift, especially while gaming. It definitely took me a lot of time to get used to it. While the red backlit keys are good to look at, I found it a little depressing because I recently used the Acer Predator G9's keyboard. The trackpad is a Windows Precision driver and it's just okay, not good and not bad either. While laptop manufacturers are opting for a more portable design by ditching even the useful ports, the same cannot be said about this laptop because it has quite a good selection of ports. On the left, you get the Kensington lock, one Ethernet, HDMI, USB-C, USB 3.0 port and one SD card reader. On the right is a USB Type-A port, a headphone jack, and a charging port. This laptop is missing a Thunderbolt 3 port, which is a bummer, but anyone who buys this laptop won't be disappointed with it much. There's a wireless AC Intel 9560 Wi-Fi card inside the laptop, which makes up for a pretty fast wireless internet connection. There's a webcam up front, which is on par with a lot of budget gaming laptops currently in the market. It is pretty bad, as you can see from these samples. The video quality is not that good too. On the audio front, there are dual loudspeakers on the laptop which produces loud and clear-cut audio, but it would have been a lot better if it could produce a bit of bass. Let's come to the conclusion now. So if you have a sum of $1,300 or ₹1,65,000 in Nepal, the Helios 300 2018 can be a decent purchase. It comes with this industry-leading 144Hz display, but bear in mind that you will either have to make compromises on the quality of graphics or in terms of frame rates. It is one of the very few laptops in this price range to feature a 144Hz panel, and I think more companies will adopt to it in 2019. And also with the 2060 GPU coming for laptops soon, I think the adoption rate will increase even more. So all in all, the best part about this laptop is the display, and I think it will lure a lot of audience. So all in all, take my word for it, this is a very good option. So that is all for the review. Tell us what you think about this device in the comment section below. Till then, I am Ratima Adhikari and keep watching Cashback.